Hello, and welcome to another Max2Play video. Max2Play is a control and installation center that comes in a pre-configured image. All adjustments and control options are accessible through a simple web interface, which you can open from any browser in your network just by typing Max2Play into your URL bar. Today, I will walk you through the web interface of the newest image for the Raspberry Pi. We also have images for other devices like the Odroid XU4 and dedicated images for certain application fields like our image for Hi-Fi Berry sound cards. If you already have a Pi, you can burn the image from our website. If not, you can purchase one of our bundles with a pre-configured image at shop.max2play.com. This you can see right here is the start page, which appears when you first enter Max2Play into your URL bar with a freshly burned image. It gives you an overview right here of all the features that Max2Play has to offer, including the premium features, which you need a premium license for. You can also see right here a little help section with links to things like the FAQs. So keep an eye out for those in the other menus. They are specific to everyone and can give you help for all the individual plugins. All our features are incorporated in such plugins, including those you can see right here. Those plugins can include installers, configuration options, and other software that you can easily add to your Pi. Which brings us to the main control center page of the image, the Settings Reboot menu. Here you can activate your premium license and start to manage your plugins. You can see the active and inactive ones right here on the plugin configuration menu. However, those are not all the plugins that Max2Play has to offer. Once your premium license is active, you can click this button right here to go to our website and the overview of our plugins in this page, which has little pictures of all the plugins. And if you've decided you want to add a new plugin, you just click on the individual plugin, it sends you to this page with a little overview of the plugin, and you click here to download, which opens this little window from which you have to copy this text and go back to your image. And right here you have the enter HTTP URL where you paste the text that you just copied and click install new plugin. However, before you do any of that, you should make sure that you click this little button right here to expand your file system. Because if your SD card is larger than 4 GB and you want to use all its space, this is the first step you need to take. The option, as you can see right here, is just a click, and once you've clicked, you just have to reboot the system again and you will be able to use all of your space, which you can see right here that I've already done that since only 33% of the SD card, which is 8 GB, is currently in use. Now we come to the plugins that are automatically active on our image. The first one is our audio player menu. It's the first one in the fold and with right because it's a great plugin. Shows you all the audio players that you can utilize right out of the box. SqueezeLight is the primary audio player. It's an open source player integrated into our control center that utilizes the SqueezeBox environment. It runs automatically from the first start and you can directly select it and control it from a SqueezeBox server in your local network. The other two pre-configured players are AirPlay and DLNA, respectively. This plugin alone makes the Raspberry Pi a versatile audio player compatible with some of the most popular music streaming software. Additionally, we have advanced options to set specific parameters, activate sound cards native to the Pi, like Hi-Fi Berry's products, and many more fine-tuning options for audio files. The next add-on we're going to talk about is the Wi-Fi and LAN menu. Here You can see if you have a Wi-Fi stick connected, which you can see here I have currently. And otherwise, it is pretty much similar to the interfaces you're probably familiar with other devices like smartphones or computers when it comes to Wi-Fi. You can click here to start a scan of the environment and find your local network. And once that is done, it'll be added here. You just have to make a tick on this load Wi-Fi interface option and set your password. And when you've done all that, you click Save All Settings and reboot the Pi, and you can already use the Wi-Fi in your local network. Here are also some other options. You can, for example, configure a certain MAC address if you're connected through LAN, and you also can set a static IP address if you would like to. Which brings us to the next menu, File System Mount, and this is our big menu for all file system needs. Here you can manage your data paths and storage points, and the first option you can see right here is the Mount Network Paths option. And here you can add a new mount point, which is pretty easy. You just have to follow those examples you have right here and adjust them to your situation to add in any mount point from the network that you desire. You also have the option to show yourself some help right here, where all the parameters are explained, and also the debug info to find out what went wrong if you couldn't put the network path into your system. The next option right here is the external drives option, and it's also pretty simple, like the Wi-Fi stick option. Once you have a USB connected, it will show you right here, and since we don't have a USB stick connected right now, it says no external devices found. Now the third option is probably the most versatile one, Samba shares. And Samba shares are network shares that you can set up for the Pi itself to access from any other device in the network, and then in turn access on the Raspberry Pi in the mount option I explained to you right above. This way you can make a path available to everybody that uses any device in the network and put media into it to use it yourself to play videos or music. This brings us to the next major plugin of Max2Play, a one-click installer of the Squeezebox server software. It's called Squeezebox Server, and it's also pretty straightforward, an installer for the Squeezebox server from which we can decide on the version we want to install. We have three options right here. I recommend either the nightly 7.9 or the normal version 7.8. And once you click it, you will have right here the link. Make sure that the link is right here, otherwise the installation will not start. And once it is, you just click this button and wait a little while until the installation is complete and you have a Squeezebox server running right on your Pi. So with the Squeezebox server running and the audio player Squeezelite running, you can now have both the hosting and the controlling and the playback go through just this one Raspberry Pi, so you have a Squeezebox environment with just one device. The Squeezebox server, of course, also comes with its own web interface to control the players in your network, but you can also use one of the many available apps for iOS and Android, like iPang or the Squeeze Commander, respectively, to access them from your smartphone or tablet. Also, as you can see here, we have a one-click solution for AirPlay as well. With this little plugin for the Squeezebox server, all your Squeezelite plugin instances, so all the Squeeze players in your environment, can be turned into AirPlay compatible players. This way, You can have both AirPlay and Squeeze Light in your environment through just the Squeezebox environment itself. This brings us to the next great open source player software that comes pre-configured on all Max2Play images. Kodi. Kodi is a popular open source media player with a huge amount of features and add-ons to fulfill all your media center needs. It is perfect for the use on a big television and can handle most video formats easily. We also have some pre-configured add-ons, which you can choose right here, like Amazon Instant Video, and you just need to connect your preferred screen via HDMI and your entertainment center is complete already. Once it's connected, you just need to click Start Kodi and the screen will already be filled with Kodi's interface and you can start playing videos. Now, to round out the pre-installed extensions on our image, we only have the Raspberry Pi settings menu left. This is the only premium plugin in this selection that can only be used when your premium license is activated. Here we can find all the preferences and settings to optimize your Pi to its highest potential. You can activate your sound cards, overclock the CPU, adjust the HDMI output, and give even more power to your USB ports if you are using a lot of USB devices. This menu is the essential one to make Pi run exactly as you prefer it and have all your applications working right. That's it for a quick overview of the Max2Play Raspberry Pi image. For the variety of other extensions, premium and free, visit our website max2play.com and watch the other videos on our YouTube channel. You can subscribe to the channel for updates on new videos and take a look at our tutorials for popular Max2Play applications on instructables.com. If you are still having questions or want to contribute to this community project, you can visit our forums or leave a comment in our Facebook page or blog. See you next time on Max2Play.